Next is throttle position sensor. I have told you earlier that the right, okay, see the picture. There is a simple throttle position sensor, right? When an engine is idling, the exhaust gas scavenging of the cylinder is poor. Okay, scavenging means simple, when there is some kind of gas are not going in your exhaust stroke, right? Some kind of gas is performed in your first stroke, that time the scavenging will be formed. Okay, so this has the effect of dilating the incoming mixture, right? Means simple कि जो आपका लास्ट स्ट्रोक रहता है, राइट, एग्जॉस्ट स्ट्रोक, राइट. तो एग्जॉस्ट स्ट्रोक में क्या होता है कि जो आपका जो बर्न गैसेस रहता है वो बाहर निकल जाता है, राइट. बट अगर किसी वजह से वो अन जो बर्न गैस बाहर नहीं जाते, राइट, थोड़ा कुछ पार्ट उसका रह जाता है, तो क्या हो जाता है कि जो फ्रेश मिक्सचर आता है उसके अंदर वो मिक्स हो जाता है और वो डाइल्यूट हो जाता है, राइट. और जो डाइल्यूट होता है तो उसकी वजह से क्या होता है कि द टेम्परेचर विल बी इंक्रीजेस, राइट. सो अर्लियर टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस, देर इज अ नॉकिंग प्रोसेस विल बी फॉर्म्ड, राइट, इन योर सिलेंडर, राइट. सो द ईसीयू मस्ट डिटेक्ट व्हेन द थ्रोटल इज इन द आइडलिंग पोजिशन सो दैट अल्टरेशन ऑफ द एयर फ्यूल रेशियो कैन ऑकर to ensure that the engine continues to run smoothly, right? Okay, I have earlier told you कि जब जो throttle valve रहता है उसके हिसाब से जो open and closing होता है, right? तो उसके हिसाब से जो air fuel ratio रहता है वो count होता है और उसके हिसाब से ECM कितना fuel चाहिए वो calculate करके आप carburetor में छोड़ता है, right? अगर और फ्यूल इंजेक्टर में छोड़ता है. ओके, देन द ईसीयू मस्ट डिटेक्ट व्हेन द थ्रोटल इज इन द आइडल पोजीशन सो द अल्टरेशन ऑफ एयर फ्यूल रेशियो कैन ऑकर टू एंश्योर दैट द इंजन कैन ऑकर टू एंश्योर दैट द इंजन कंटिन्यूस रन स्मूथली, राइट. एट फुल इंजन लोड एंड फुल थ्रोटल द मिक्सचर एयर फ्यूल रेशियो नीड्स enriching, so the ECU needs a signal to show that the throttle is fully open. Okay, these duties are performed by the throttle position switch. Figure shows how the action of throttle position sensor is based on the principle of potential divider. The sensor produces a voltage which is related to throttle position. The voltage signal is conducted to the ECU where it is used in conjunction with other inputs to determine the correct fueling for a given condition, right? Okay, the next sensor is temperature sensor. Okay, so the temperature sensor, A commonly used device for sensing temperature is the thermistor. A thermistor utilizes the concept of negative temperature coefficient. Most electrical conductors have positive temperature coefficient. This means that the hotter the conductor gets, the higher is its electrical resistance, right? So when we have using a temperature sensor, that time a simple thermistor are using, right, in your vehicle. Okay, so this thermistor operate differently. Its resistance gets lower as its temperature, okay, increases, and this is a characteristics of semiconductors for temperature. So the simple temperature sensor, right, you have to see the diagram or picture of the simple engine coolant temperature sensor, right. That sensor will be utilizing the in your radiator, right. So when the temperature will be rise in a 70 degree centigrade, right? That sensor will be open, right? And your coolant or coolant water will be goes through the down, right? So when the positions will be up and down, right? So the fan will be rotating. So that fan is simple to cool that simple water, and that water goes to the engine cylinder, right? Or your simple water jackets, right? To cool the engine, right? So there is simple water coolant radiators are using, temperature sensor are using your radiators, okay? So in this next sensor is manifold absolute pressure sensor, right? Simple, there is a manifold, right? Manifold, simple, you have to inject some air in your manifold, right? So when they have the air, right, will be sucked, right, in your cylinder, so that air have some calculated quantity, right? So that absolute pressure will be recognized that sensor, right? So that is simple manifold absolute sensor. So several MAP sensors configuration have been used in automotive application. The earlier sensors were derived from aerospace instrumentation concept, but these provided more expensive than desirable for automotive applications and have been replaced with more cost effective designs, right? Simple, that MAP sensor, right, are used in simple aerospace, right? But in a modern vehicle, right, there are also simply MAP sensors are used, okay? So it is interesting to note that none of the MAP sensors in use measure manifold pressure directly, right, but instead measure the displacement of a diaphragm that is deflected by manifold pressure, okay? We have to discuss earlier that there is a MAF sensors, right? So that simple, the air will be sucked, right, with the help of that simple manifold, right? So that air will be simply circulate or simple redistributed to the engine, okay? So the detail of the diaphragm displacement and the measurement of the displacement vary from one configuration to another, right? So next sensor is NOx sensor, okay? I have told you earlier that when there is a scavenging in your cylinder, right, the temperature will be rises, right, and at the time of compression, right, when there is end of the compression, the ignition will be start. But when there is scavenging or produces that before the before the ignition timing, right, the distributor or your spark plug will be spark plug is ignite the fuel, and that pressure not increases, right, at that time. So the knocking will be produces, right? So a NOx sensor that is commonly used in engine control system utilizes the photoelectric generator effect. That is, the sensing element produces a small electric charge when it is compressed and then relaxed. Simply agar aapko pata chalega ki jo bhi sensor hai, right, wo sense karta hai aur wo send karta hai, right, wo receive karta hai aur ECU aur ECM ko kya karta hai, send karta hai. To wo kaise send karta hai? With the help of voltage, right? Voltage wo kya karta hai? Send karta hai. So that coding of that voltage, right, different types of coding in your simple in your system, right, ECM or ECU, right? So that voltage will be produces a code in your ECM or ECU. So we have to know that that kind of sensor will be told you that ki what kind of pressure, temperature or positions of your parts. Okay, so materials such as quartz and some ceramic like PZT, a mixture of platinum, zirconium and titanium, right, are effective in piezoelectric application. In the application shown, the NOx sensors is located on the engine block adjacent to cylinder number 3. We have to see that diagram, right? Simple, a NOx sensor on the system, right? We have to use, okay? So, because combustion NOx is most likely to occur close to TDS in the any cylinder. TDS means throttle, right? Throttle position जो दिखाता है, right? जो throttle opening और close करता है, that is simple TDC, right? So means the top dead center, अगर आप जो combustion chamber है, right? मतलब compression chamber अगर ऊपर आता है, तो वो at the end of compression वो आपको ignition start होता है, right? So उसके हिसाब से अगर आपको चलना है, तो NOx sensor में क्या होता है कि वो डिटेक्ट करता है कि कब कंप्रेशन चेंबर के एंड में, राइट, वो इग्निशन स्टार्ट होता है, राइट. सो इन दिस व्हेन NOx हैज कीज टू ECM विल एडवांस द इग्नाइट, राइट, इग्निशन इन स्टेप्स बैक टू इट्स नॉर्मल सेटिंग. द मैकेनिज्म बाय व्हिच वाइब्रेशन अराइजिंग फ्रॉम NOx आर कन्वर्टेड टू इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. Okay, the sensor is accurately designed and the center bolt that pretensions the piezoelectric crystal is accurately torqued. The steel washer that makes up the seismic mass has very precise dimension. Okay, when combustion NOx occurs, the resulting mechanical vibrations are transmitted by the seismic mass to the piezoelectric crystal. The squeezing up and relaxing of the crystal in response to this action, right? When there is a NOx in your vehicle, that time firstly it is goes down to the seismic mass, right? Then piezoelectric crystal, and that they are squeezing up and relaxing to the crystal. Response action produces small electrical signal, right? That oscillates at the some frequency as the NOx sensor elements. The electrical signal is conducted away from the crystal by wires that are secured to suitable points on the crystal. Okay. Then next is lambda sensor, means exhaust gas oxygen sensor, right? Okay, or we have to simple that O2 sensors bolte usko. Okay, then in order for the exhaust emission catalyst to operate correctly, the air fuel ratio must be kept close to 15:1 by mass, right? Simple, जो भी एयर फ्यूल रेशो रहेगा, राइट, उसके हिसाब से एग्जॉस्ट गैस के थ्रू आपका जो बर्न गैसेस है वो बाहर निकलेगा. ओके, द सिंपल एंड इट इज द एग्जॉस्ट गैस ऑक्सीजन सेंसर, EGO बोलते हैं उसको, एग्जॉस्ट गैस ऑक्सीजन, और सिंपल दैट असिस्ट द ECM टू कीप द एयर फ्यूल रेशो विद इन द रिक्वायर्ड लिमिट्स. मीन्स जो EGO सेंसर है, राइट, वो बताता है कि आपका जो ऑक्सीजन रेशो है, राइट, वो जो बर्न गैसेस में वो कितना है, और उसके हिसाब से ही अगली बार जो भी एयर फ्यूल रेशो रहता है उसको कॉन्स्टेंटली फॉलो करेगा, राइट, और उसके हिसाब से EGO भी क्या करेगा, वो प्रोसीजर क्या है, वो जो भी कोड, जो भी वोल्टेज है वो भेजेगा और जो ECM रहेगा वो रिसीव करेगा. ओके, the EGO sensor constantly monitors the oxygen content of the exhaust gas and hence the air fuel ratio at the engine intake since the percentage of oxygen in the exhaust gas is an acute measure of the air fuel ratio of the mixture entering the engine cylinder. Right? Okay. Figure shows the relation between the oxygen content of the exhaust gas and the air fuel ratio of the mixture entering the combustion chamber of the engine. Right? Simple? So, there is a air fuel ratio, right? So, there is a simple oxygen content in the exhaust gas, right, will be measured, and that sent to be the ECM, right? And that ECM will be calculate what amount of air fuel ratio are filling in the cylinder, right? When there is excess, then there is a air fuel ratio will be changed, right? Okay. So the information from the EGO sensor is fed back to the ECM so that the amount of fuel injected into the engine may be changed to ensure that the air fuel ratio is kept within the required limits. It is common practice to refer to air fuel ratio that is gives chemically correct combustion as lambda is equal to 0, right? Means chemically correct fuel air fuel ratio, that is 1, right? When there is a less than 1, right, the mixture is rich, means there is a fuel ratio is bigger than the air, right? So lambda percentage, right, mixture of weak, right, means it is greater than 1, right? So that time the mixture is weak. Okay, so there is simple types of sensor we have studied. Next lecture we have studied the actuators. Okay.